Well, good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here with a quick look at the North American stock markets for Monday morning. In the pre-market this morning, stock index futures and commodities are above fair value, so we are looking for some buying at the open on Monday morning. Well, this week is a Fed week, and so we don't want to be taking any large positions ahead of the Fed meeting. The market will be playing that game. Are you smarter than a fifth grader? It's one thing to know what the Fed is going to say. It's another thing to also know how the market is going to react to it. And so that's a very hard game to play, and we'll just sit on our hands until that resolves itself later in the week. Now, last week we traded through our price target of 21.25 several times, and where did we find support? At the June highs. Friday was an inside day. We were down just a little over 8 points on Friday. On Monday morning in the pre-market, we're up 8 points. So we're not really trading outside of Friday's range right now. If we look at a 60-minute chart, you can see the low that we had, and then we tested it a couple of times. And so far, that the low off the June highs is holding. On the way up, we've got an open gap here. We came up and found resistance at the bottom of that open gap. And so the top of it, that gap is still in play. And then, of course, we have a big one up here, which the NASDAQ was able to run right through on the back of course, Apple Computer. Now, there's Deutsche Bank, was in the news on Friday, big gap lower. Anytime that you're looking at a European or Asian stock that trades in North America, you're going to see a lot more gaps than the average stock chart would have, because of course all the news is happening overseas. Most of the news is happening while the New York or the Toronto market is closed. And so there's the big gap down that we had on Friday, and we're down again on Monday. And so there is a lot of tension, of course, on European banks, and there's some Italian banks that could be on the brink of failing. And so just keep an eye. That's a huge worry for the market going forward, that one of those banks collapses. Now, if you look at a monthly chart at Deutsche Bank, you know, weakness in Deutsche Bank is nothing that the market hasn't been dealing with for a long, long time. So the fact that it gapped lower on a short-term daily chart really doesn't show up that much on a monthly chart. And so there's a lot of anticipation that one of these banks is going to break at some point. It just hasn't happened yet. Now, looking at a couple of weekly charts, and that's all we'll look at today. There's the S&P 500, looking at the weekly panic zone chart. You can see the early warning signals up at the top of the screen there, and then the bars start to turn color. We are still on a weekly sell signal for the S&P 500. We were up 11 points last week. There's the NASDAQ. It was up nearly 3% on the week, while the TSX was lower. The TSX traded through the lower channel line but did not close there. We're only, 43 points away from a weekly sell signal for the TSX. Now, what propped the markets up last week was the Apple Computer, up over 11% on the week. And so the, you know, that's a NASDAQ 100 stock, it's a Dow 30 stock, it's an S&P 500 stock, and that did a great job of holding the market up. Another stock and sector that held the market up last week was the SOX index and Intel. Intel was up over 6% on the week. Again, major stock in all the major indexes, and certainly did its best job to hold the market up. Now, at the other end of the scale, one sector that's getting hit hard right now, and it's been in a long-term downtrend, is the solar stocks. So just a couple of examples: Canadian Solar, First Solar, and SunPower, all getting hit hard last week. Now, looking at gold and silver stocks, you know, I still have hope for this sector, but our line in the sand is going to be the recent low. The XAU was down just 2% last week, 2.10%, while the TSX gold index was down 0.61%, the same as the TSX itself. And so I'm really not going to give up on this sector until we take out the recent low. Gold is up in the pre-market this morning, so I'm expecting gold and silver stocks to trade higher on Monday. Now, there's the VIX, and the VIX is still on a buy signal. So the market's not going to settle down until we get the VIX back on a weekly sell signal, and then we could expect higher prices for some length of time. Right now, we are still dealing with the VIX on a buy signal, on a weekly buy signal, and that, of course, tells us to expect more volatility in the market. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. I really don't want to get overly excited about being long or short the market ahead of the Fed meeting. We'll just have to wait until the meeting happens and not only concern ourselves with what the Fed says, of course, but how the market reacts to it. And that's the most important thing and the hardest thing to get ahead of going into a Fed meeting. Have a great day, folks, and next time you'll hear my voice is on Tuesday morning.